An invasion that spans continents. Triggered by humans.
They didn't choose to be released in an entirely different environment, but they're here.
The lionfish. Along the Atlantic coast, they've gone from population zero to top predator in mere decades.
I'm talking about, in some cases, 100 lionfish on one reef site that may be the size of your car.
We constantly go back and forth from being appalled at what we see, but being excited by our ability to witness those things.
What has made them so successful?
Copy that, be advised. We are heading up for lionfish.
Yeah, that's it. All right, keep it there. Yeah, bring it up.
And what, if anything, can stop them?
We bring it to a restaurant where they sell them, where they sell the lionfish.
What's the average depth that you normally put this down at?
Truly out of recreational diving limits, deep water. There we go.
Nice.
We're ready to go.
Ocean Invaders, right now on Nova. The Argentine black and white tegu in Florida. African hippos in Colombia. South American cane toads in Australia. Species are being introduced to new places like never before.
Asian giant hornet is so much bigger and faster and stronger.
Some are harmless and actually make our lives better, while others become invasive, causing harm and spreading uncontrollably.
We short-circuit the geographic barriers between these species.
But it's in the ocean where an invasive species has wreaked so much havoc, it's considered one of the most successful of them all. The lionfish. And the ocean, well, that's my territory. I'm Danny Washington, an ocean explorer and science communicator. I've always been drawn to the mysteries of the underwater world. So when I learned that an invasion of epic proportions, spanning continents, was happening below the surface, I had to investigate. What I really want to know is, why are lionfish a threat? What makes them so invasive? And what can be done about it? The Gulf of Mexico is one of the regions that has been hit hardest by the invasion. So today, I've come to participate in a fish survey to get a closer look at these ocean invaders.
Well, my mission is to find lionfish and during the survey, so I'm really looking forward to that. I know that they love to hang around wrecks or any type of structure underwater, so curious to see how many we'll find.
I join Coastal Resource Manager Alex Fogg at the Big Dog, a U.S. Air Force vessel sunk in 2021.
So where maybe there's a staircase or maybe an open door where there's some nooks and crannies for them to hang out, that's where you want to be looking for them.
Okay. We'll help if we can.
All right, cool. And I think the universal signal for lionfish, I mean, if I remember correctly, it's this one right here.
Correct, yep.
All right.
Yeah, pretty easy one to pick out.
Great. So if you can point them out to me, let me know when you see some, and I'll make sure to tally it down. Okay, well, I think we should get suited up.
The Big Dog was not a casualty of a hurricane or torpedo. It was intentionally sunk as a part of an artificial reef program